The horse manure I picked up this weekend is heating up very quickly. In fact, I dropped it off Saturday morning and measured the temperature Sunday morning at approximately 75 degrees Fahrenheit. By Monday morning, the temperature had reached 162 degrees. That's the highest reading I've ever seen on my compost thermometer. It's actually too hot. But it will cool down to a more reasonable composting temperature, where I hope it will stay for an extended period before I need to turn it. But this heat source has me itching to plant some things. There's nothing scheduled according to my planting notes, but I don't want this heat to go to waste. So I'm going to try an experiment and plant tomatoes almost a month earlier than usual. I normally plant tomatoes on April 20th each spring. For years, when I started farming commercially, I was trying to beat everyone to market with tomatoes and planted them super early, even as early as January. Unfortunately, I just didn't have the infrastructure or time to pull that off. I can't count the number of times I lost entire trays of seedlings because I didn't have enough heat, or I didn't get outside to water soon enough, or open the tunnel. That was before I discovered the idea that horse manure can be used as a heat source for farming and gardening. By the time I came across references to Parisian market gardens of the mid-1700s, began researching, became enthralled, and started experimenting, I already had it ingrained in my head that it is futile to plant heat-loving crops too early. After years of refinement, I landed on April 20th as the ideal date to plant tomatoes here in my central Maine hardiness zone 5. Any earlier, and even if I'm able to keep the plants from freezing or burning up, and they get too large and leggy before I can securely transplant them even into the hoop house. But there were other problems causing this difficulty as well. I don't think the pots I was putting the seedlings into after germination were big enough. I also don't think I spaced the pots far enough apart. So this year, I'm going to try again. I now have years of experience proving the efficacy of the natural heat mat. I have several nursery pots into which to put the seedlings after germination, giving them more room. And I have the determination to get outside every morning before it gets too hot under the low tunnel, and outside every night before it gets too cold. And even if nothing works the way I'd like, I know I can always plant on April 20th and get a crop. So, essentially, I have little to lose but a few seeds, which I saved myself and so haven't cost anything really, and the time it will take to plant and care for the plants. That time is my most valuable input into this experiment. But if you knew anything about my love for tomatoes, you'd understand why I'm willing to make that investment, even on a chance I get tomatoes early. When I plant multiple varieties in the same tray, whether it has cells or not, there are several reasons I try to put space between the two varieties that may look similar. First, for many of my crops, I save seed. That being the case, I need to keep track of what varieties are where out in the field. So I would not put two different kinds of cherry tomatoes right next to each other in the flat because, in the hectic pace of transplanting and over the course of management over the months before transplanting, it would be easy to mix them up. Instead, I like to put, say, a large slicing tomato into the same tray as a cherry tomato. Secondly, I like to keep track of varieties and their characteristics. That can be anything from taste to vigor to whether or not the variety does better inside a hoop house or out in the field, etc. Keeping notes on all of this would be a waste of time if I had two red cherry tomato varieties in the same row and didn't know it. But when I'm planting things out into the ground and I have to go back to the cart or even back to the hoop house to get another variety that looks similar, there's a much lower chance I'm going to plant something in the wrong place as it's related to these issues.
Gotta go up to the shed and get the tags for those tomatoes. Just the ones I have. Stop on the way and check on the sap. Thank you.
It's late, and I don't want to take these out to the hoop house, open it up, open the heat mat, put them in, then close everything up again. It won't hurt them to be in the basement for a few hours overnight. I do want to water them, however, to at least get the germination process started. And since I need to water the nursery trees Michael and I grafted last weekend, I'll accomplish both tasks at once.